And our second reading is from the Gospel of Luke, two short verses in chapter 17. Listen again for God's word to you. The apostles said to the Lord, "Increase our faith." The Lord replied, "If you had faith the size of a mustard seed, you could say to this mulberry tree, 'Be uprooted and planted in the sea,' and it would obey you." May God add blessing and understanding to these readings from God's word. Let us pray. May the words of my mouth and the meditations of all our hearts be acceptable in your sight, O Lord, our rock and our redeemer. Amen. The images are haunting. A young Syrian boy crying in anguish this week, in which 100 children were killed in Aleppo. A young African-American girl in Charlotte pleading through tears for respect, equality, and life for people of color. A Syrian rescue worker overcome with emotion when the newborn baby, presumed dead, begins to cry. The family of Jacob Hall cradling the 6-year-old victim of a school shooting in South Carolina as he lay dying. So much conflict and not enough peace. So much grief and angst and not enough reconciliation. Too much despair, just too much, and not enough healing. And here we are on Peacemaking Sunday, when we also share the Lord's Supper with Christians all around the world. On this day, when our focus is directed toward worldwide peace and community, it seems fitting that the lectionary readings include a portion of Lamentations. Noted biblical scholar Werner Lemke, who taught here in Rochester at the Divinity School, notes that Lamentations is first and foremost an eloquent expression of grief that helps survivors come to terms with the historical calamity that they had gone through. As such, it is very timely for our moment in history as well. The time to lament is upon us, and when we read Lamentations with a contrite heart, we find ourselves in its verses. How long, O Lord? When we cry out with the text in a spirit of honesty, we confess, "For too long, O Lord, we ignored your pleas on behalf of the oppressed." Lamentations makes us confront emotions we would rather push aside. And then, in the midst of our deep grieving and worry, God speaks a word of hope and comfort. The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. God's mercies are new every morning. This is familiar territory for those who engage in peacemaking, those who emotionally and physically enter spaces of conflict and tension without violent means in order to bring peace. I had interaction with two such peacemakers in the last week, and I want to share just a bit of their stories. Last Monday, I met Arij, a lovely young Palestinian woman from Bethlehem. She is one of the Presbyterian International Peacemakers itinerating in this country during October to highlight stories of peacemaking in conflict-torn locations. Arij herself embodies the conflict of her area, and she is eloquent in describing the difficulties of life in Palestine. When she was a young teen, she went through a time when she didn't want to be Palestinian, and she didn't want to be Christian either. To be Palestinian to her meant to have political enemies who want to take your land, bulldoze your house, separate you from your fellow Palestinians just a few miles away, and in all ways make life unbearably difficult and impoverished. At the same time, to be Christian required loving your enemies, those very same enemies. Arij didn't want either identity. She didn't want to have enemies, and she didn't want to love enemies. Some years later, as a young adult, she discovered the Kairos document, a declaration of Christian Palestinians to the world about what is happening in Palestine. It begins with this introduction. Our word is a cry of hope with love, prayer, and faith in God. We address it first of all to ourselves and then to all the churches and Christians in the world, asking them to stand against injustice and apartheid, urging them to work for a just peace. We proclaim our word based on our Christian faith and our sense of Palestinian belonging, a word of faith, hope, and love. These words carried peace into the personal struggle of Arij. Here were others claiming both Palestinian and Christian identities and speaking about hope. It changed her life. She currently works as the communications and administrative officer for Kairos Palestine, where she is liaison and a networker and oversees communications with churches and organizations. Jeremiah laments that the roads to Zion mourn. And indeed, many of those same roads in that same region mourn today. Yet the steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. God's mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Surely peace is in the land. Another peacemaker bringing peace to our land is right here in Rochester through the YWCA. A week ago Thursday, Ginny and Norm and I attended a luncheon put on by the Rochester Area Community Foundation, the ones who gave us the grant through Wayne County funds for our free community meal. We were there to celebrate honorees, to celebrate the work that goes on in the name of the Community Foundation. And one of the honorees was the director of the YWCA, the Women's Christian Organization, for work that they have been doing to build racial bridges across racial divides. One of the programs that the woman talked about is called Person to Person. And it is a program where two people of different races come together over a 9-month period. They meet every 2 to 3 weeks and talk about their reactions to life, to what's going on in their lives. They share their lives together and the lives of those they connect with, intentionally talking every 2 to 3 weeks over the school year. And then many of them continue on because the relationships become so deep, so impacting, so important. They have told the YWCA organizers that this program has changed their lives, that they have met people they would never have met, that they understand things now that they could never have understood without that personal interaction. Person to person, coming together to understand. That's really what brings peace into places where there is too little of it. Jeremiah cries, "The roads to Zion mourn." Many of our roadways cry out too, with far too much bloodshed and animosity born of not understanding each other. Yet the steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. God's mercies never come to an end. They are new every morning. Surely peace is in the land. Albert Einstein once said, "Peace cannot be kept by force. It can only be achieved by understanding." On this Peacemaking Sunday, let us all dedicate ourselves in the mercies of God to this task on which our lives and the life of the world hangs. Amen.